Good morning. Welcome to Table Talk, brought to you by Christian Reporter News. We're here downtown San Angelo today on the river, right across from the river stage, and we've been talking to you about the drought in San Angelo and the lack of water and what it does to our precious trees, which really and truly is an asset to San Angelo. It brings in tourism, and it's just nice to live among the trees, how cool it is. Today, I have with us some water experts, I believe, that actually do the work for the city in our parks, our recreation, and keep the grounds, and have been working with John Begno these days to save our trees and get into watering. And I'm going to look over here at Carl and let him tell us a little bit about that.
Well, I'm looking at the whole river project. This has been a labor of love for us since about 2003, when we were asked to look at different public projects that could be funded with the half-cent sales tax. And we did that. We had the referendum for the half-cent sales tax that passed, so we got money to do the river project as well as some other projects. We addressed those other projects first, the sports complex, the renovation of the convention center, and got the designer on board to do the river project. We had to do lots and lots of different studies and preparations for the river project, lots of different permits, hydrological studies, you name it, archaeological surveys. So it's been a very complex and detailed project. We kicked off the project after we've done the original design in October of 2011. It's going to take about 2 years to finish. We'll finish up in the middle of September. And the time we've done the kicked off the project is right when the drought hit. So we had lack of rainfall, we had lack of irrigation, we had to drain the river to do the bank stabilization for the river project. We had high temperatures. A lot of the trees just really can't transpire. They can't bring the water from the ground, which may not be there, up to survive and to live. And then also, we've lost trees, and particularly most of those have been more species specific. The pecan trees, we've lost a fair number of pecan trees and a few red oak trees, ones that are less tolerant to lack of having water in the ground. And it's a total of about 60 trees that we've lost throughout the river project there along the river.
Well, I know we have plans. And by the way, this is Carl White. He is the department head of our Parks and Recreations. And Carl has a love for parks. If you're lucky, Reed is fortunate enough, read his column that he has in the paper sometime. I'm going to look over here to Shane. This is Shane Kelton, who is also very knowledgeable in the watering, what we're doing, and how we're changing things. Shane, you want to tell us a little bit about that?
We've started back last May, and of course, coming out of last fall as well, too, during last summer, we actually started coming along the river in an effort to try to save the trees that we have with actual water tanks and city water trucks as well, coming in and actually starting a watering program where we actually go from tree to tree to tree, specifically trying, concentrating mostly on the on pecan trees, but also on the oaks and all the oaks, whether it's live oaks, chicopin, or a red oak. We're concentrated on all of them, but we've primarily tried to focus on the ones that we knew were stressing really bad. And we've put up drip systems on them that are actually hooked into our water trailers and our water trucks, and just focusing on watering those trees as well. We've taken, you know, down here along the river, it's been really, really tough to keep the water on them since the river was drained, since the irrigation systems have been basically shut off and defunct as we're putting the new systems in. So it has been a challenge for us to actually, you know, with staffing issues that we face lately, to keep it up. But we really have worked it really hard. And even since coming into this spring, since the 1st of May, we started our tree watering program again. And it's every day. We have some employees that we've hired through Labor Ready that's all they do every day. With our staffing shortage, we've had to look elsewhere and be creative on how we staff some of these things, and that's how we focused on it, was to get Labor Ready guys, and we get the same two guys every day, and they're very dedicated to the tree project, and we do have city staff going by and supervise them from time to time, but that's what they do all day long, every day, is go out and water trees. That's their job and their focus.
Well, I want to add in here, we've talked about drip systems, and we've talked about the river, and course, most people know, or the last couple of years, almost 2 years, things have kind of been torn up down here with a lot of work going on, the hiking trails, biking, and more family-oriented projects down here. So I want to first talk about the drip system that you can use at your homes. Winky, you're more familiar with the foundations. You want to save things. The drip system, the same that you can use, or soaker hose, if you want to talk a little bit about that right quick as to how they can use to save their trees and foundations.
Yeah, pecan trees, which we have so many here in San Angelo, are probably your primary concern. According to John Begno, a pecan tree in the heat of the summer needs 750 gallons of water every 21 days, or they will die. And he recommends watering them about every 2 weeks. And the best way, of course, to water a pecan tree, if you're just thinking about the tree itself, is to get you a soaker hose and loop it around the tree out about the end of the drip line, and about 360 degrees around the tree, and water it, and put your 750 gallons in there if it's a mature pecan tree, and then wait 2 weeks and do it again. But the soaker hose, of course, would be hooked up to just a regular garden hose. And the drought actually started in about 1992, and it rocked along here. It's been pretty bad, but of course 2011 is what really killed us, because it was such a bad year, probably the worst in the state historically, and these trees that have been stressed for the long-term drought were just knocked in the head by the 2011-2012 situation. And so we've got to pay more attention to our trees than we otherwise would have, because historically we're in a real bad time.
You know, the use, it same applies on commercial properties. You know, the city is taking some advice from John Begno, the former county extension agent, that everyone knows about the different species of trees that we have here. Shane, what kind of tree are we sitting under right here? I'm not familiar with this variety.
This one right here is an elm tree, and we have all through the parks, we have elm trees, we have a few ash trees, we have a ton of live oaks and pecans along the river here. We also have a multitude of red oaks, some chickpin oaks, bald cypress, Chinese pistachio. There's tons of different trees. Vitex for landscaping trees/shrubs. So we have a lot of different varieties.
We point that out because that presents a problem in how much water the various varieties of trees need. So I think that's very important to identifying our problems down here, why some are dying or some are not, and it's the variety of trees. Carl, it's been a challenge.
It has been a challenge. But in some ways, at this point, we keep the pecan trees alive that we can, but it does present an opportunity for us to go back and plant species trees that are a little more tolerant of drought conditions.
And that's planting. That's very crucial to running parks. I know you guys are constantly planting and doing, and they have a thankless job. I know that they work range fires and do and help with their knowledge, and they love the area and love the land. So it's a gift. It is a gift. John Begnell and I were talking about it last night. The city is very, very fortunate to have people such as Carl and Shane, their gift, their knowledge, and their love for the city. And what we're trying to do during this drought, what they are trying to do during this drought time. Is there anything else that you would like to add?
From our standpoint, it's not just, we're talking here today about the river, but it's our park systems in general. We're trying to do the best we can to conserve the water, because water is so precious for all of us, whether it's the, we're talking about trees and landscapes and shrubs and too, but we want to, as the community is trying to grow, and we're going through this growth spell right now, we have to be even more mindful of the water that we're using and the water that we have available. So we're taking it as a concept as a whole throughout the entire city of conservations and being mindful and trying to focus our water where it is most critical to try to save some of our our larger species trees and specimen trees that are really what makes San Angelo and make our oasis in the desert here in San Angelo. And so we are really trying to work that direction to keep it as aesthetically pleasing as possible without being wasteful of our water and our resources that we do have here.
You know, we are very conscious of what it takes to run the parks for the public's enjoyment. And, you know, if you see things going on down in here that maybe you don't think is according to Hoyle, do not hesitate to call the city at 657-4142, I believe. And
4241.
Thank you, guys. I'm sorry. Be sure and let us know if you see something that seems out of order or you're curious about or would like to know more about. But also, I want you to be thinking about out there what you would like us to talk about next. And if you would call CAT, our sponsor, at 325-716-9190 or send her an email at christianreporternews@gmail.com. What you want to talk about, what you want to hear about, and what we can look at, we are more than willing to look at it if it's things that are related to the city and related to what you care about. Any closing remarks from Carl?
Well, I'm personally really excited about finishing up the river project. Of course, the contractor will finish in the middle of September, but we've got a few more things to dress up after that. We're planning a Riverfest event in the middle of October, 18th and 19th of October. With lots of different activities and music and races along the river. And I'm really excited about getting the public back down here to enjoy the river. When the conditions are better than they are now, with the rainfall, we'll come back in and plant some more trees to reestablish the green canopy that is in the river parks.
Jane?
We just want to, again, reinforce what Ms. Farmer said. If y'all see if people see things wrong out in the city, whether it's in the park system, it's in the anywhere in the park system, the sports fields, please contact the city and let us know. We have so many acres that we have to cover and only a few employees to get there. So we can't be eyes and ears everywhere. So we rely on the public to be our eyes and ears. And please call us and let us know, because we do. We want to know so we can get out there and stop anything that may be wrong.
And again, my name is Charlotte Farmer for Table Talk, provided by Christian Reporter News. That number again is 325-716-9190 or christianreporternews@gmail.com. Thank you so much for joining us today, and let us hear from you.